This is Ray Bradbury. Join me for the next 30 minutes on a tour through time and space. Come along to the far future. Follow me into a strange past with stories that almost could be or might have been. Real or unreal, this is Bradbury 13.
The ravine was a dynamo that never stopped running, night or day. There was a great moving hum, a bubbling and murmuring of creature. It smelled like a greenhouse of secret vapors and ancient washed shales and quicksands. And in the shade of warm trees, with her hands at either side of her like the oars of a delicate craft, lay Elizabeth Ransell. Her face moonlit, her eyes wide and like flint, her tongue sticking from her mouth. Ray Bradbury's The Ravine.
Douglas, would you like some more lemonade?
No, thanks, Miss Lavinia. But I'll take another cookie.
It's 7 o'clock. You'd better run along now, Douglas. Your mother will be worrying.
You going to the show with Miss Francine and Miss Helen?
Yes, I am, Mr. Nosey. Now you get on home. Shoo!
Bye. See you later.
What a scamp. Oh, Francine!
Lavinia, are you all ready?
Yes. Let me lock the door.
My, you look nice tonight.
Oh, I feel good, too. It's a fine night for a movie.
Isn't it, though?
Where are you going, girl?
To the Elite Theater to see Charlie Chaplin.
Won't catch me out on no night like this. Not with the lonely ones strangling women left and right. I'm locking myself up in my closet with a gun.
Oh, bosh. Go on, then.
I'm going.
That woman.
Lavinia? You don't believe all that about the lonely one, do you?
Those women like to see their tongues dance, that's all.
Just the same, Hattie McDulless was killed 2 months ago. Roberta Ferry the month before, and now Elizabeth Ramsell's disappeared.
Hattie McDulless was a silly girl walked off with a traveling man, I bet.
But the others, all of them strangled. Their tongues sticking out of their mouths, they say.
Honestly, Francine.
Lavinia, maybe we shouldn't go to the show tonight. The lonely one might follow and kill us.
Francine!
I don't like the ravine. Oh, look at it, will you?
You're just being silly.
It won't be me coming back through this old ravine so darn late tonight. It'll be you, Lavinia. You move down the steps and over the bridge and maybe the lonely one there.
Hush!
It'll be you alone on the path. Listening to your shoes, not me. You all alone on the way back to your house, Lavinia. Don't you get lonely living in that house?
Old maids love to live alone. Let's take the shortcut.
What?
Yes, through the ravine.
Oh, I'm afraid.
It's early. The lonely one won't be out till late. Come on, I'll take your arm.
Oh. like a hothouse down here. Oh, insects.
Just mosquitoes.
Let's run.
No.
What's that?
Fireflies, Francine. Aren't they beautiful? Twinkling like little stars.
Well, I don't...
What is it?
There. Under the tree.
Where?
There.
No, don't scream. Don't. Oh, it's Elizabeth. Elizabeth Ramsell.
She's dead. Oh, she's dead. Dad, you're gonna see me dead.
We better get the police. Oh.
Terminate our investigation, I wonder, is there anything else you saw that you could tell us?
No, we told you everything. Come on, Francine.
You might drop by the station tomorrow for a little more questioning.
We'll be there.
Oh, hold on to me, Lavinia. I'm cold. I've never been so cold in my life.
It's like December.
You want an escort, ladies?
No, we'll make it.
Will we?
Of course we will.
Oh, I've never seen a dead person before.
It's only 8:30. We'll pick up Helen and get on to the show.
The show?
It's what we need. We've got to forget this. It's not good to remember. We'll go to the show as if nothing happened.
Oh, Lavinia, you don't mean it.
I never meant anything more in my life. We need to laugh and forget.
But Elizabeth's back there. Your friend, my friend.
We can't help her now. We can only help ourselves. Come on. There's Helen. Come on now, chin up. There you are.
I thought you'd never get here. You're only an hour late, that's all.
Well, we went...
Helen, someone found Elizabeth Ramsell in the ravine.
Oh, dead? Was she dead?
Yes.
Oh. Who found her?
We don't know.
I've got a notion to go back in the house and lock the doors.
Helen, please come to the show with us. It'll be good for us all.
Poor Elizabeth. I feel a chill in here. I think I'll get a sweater.
We found her. Why didn't you tell her?
Why upset her? Tomorrow's plenty of time. Shh, here she comes.
All set. There. Locked tight. Oh, it's all so ghastly.
Let's hurry. We can still make the cereal.
We're crazy being out on a night like this.
Lonely one won't kill three ladies. There's safety in numbers. And besides, it's too soon. The killings always come a month apart.
Well, I suppose.
Gotcha!
Hey, I'm the lonely one. Let me!
Frank, if you ever do a childish thing like that again, may someone riddle you with bullets.
What a horrible thing to do.
You monster!
Say, I didn't mean nothing.
Go away. Haven't you heard about Elizabeth Ramsell found dead in the ravine?
Well, no, I...
You running around scaring women. Jumping out from trees like that. Don't ever speak to us again.
Oh, now.
Get out of the way. Go.
I was just funny.
A lot of fun you are, Mr. Lonely One. Go take a look at Elizabeth Ramsell's face and see if it's funny. Good night.
Oh, what a horrible night.
Francine, it was only a joke. You know, Frank. Why is she crying so hard?
I'll tell you when we get downtown. We're going to the show no matter what. Now, come on now. Get your money ready. We're almost there.
Can we stop at the drugstore? I'd like to get some peppermint chews.
Good idea. I'll get some, too. Come on.
Evening, ladies. What can I do for you?
I need a nickel's worth of peppermint chews for eating in the show and some for Helen, too.
All right. A nickel's worth.
Yes, please.
You sure look pretty tonight, ladies. You look so nice and cool this afternoon when you was in for a chocolate soda.
Why, thank you.
In fact, you look so cool that someone asked after you.
Oh?
A man sitting at the counter watched you walk out.
said to me, "Say, who's that?" "Why, that's Lavinia Nibbs, prettiest maiden lady in town," I said. "She's beautiful," he said. "Where does she live?"
"Oh, you didn't give him her address, I hope."
I guess I didn't think. Told him over on Park Street, near the Ravine, and well, tonight, with him finding that body and all, I thought, what have I done?
Oh, how could you?
I'm sorry. Of course, maybe it was nothing.
Of course it was nothing, Mr. Spencer. Here's the nickel.
Well, there's no charge for those peppermints.
Well, I know what I'm going to do right now.
Helen, where are you going? Helen, where are you going?
I'm going to call a taxi to take us all home. I'll not be part of a hunting party for you, Lavinia. That man was up to no good asking about you. Do you want to be dead in the ravine next?
It was just a man.
So is Frank Dillon a man. Maybe he's the lonely one.
I made the druggist give me a description. I made him tell me what he looked like. A stranger in a dark suit. Sort of pale and thin.
We're all overwrought. If I'm the next victim, I'm the next victim.
Lavinia?
There's all too little excitement in life, especially for a maiden lady 33 years old. So don't you mind if I enjoy it?
Enjoy it?
Yes.
Oh.
Anyway, it's silly. I'm not beautiful.
Oh, but you are, Lavinia. You're the loveliest lady in town now that Elizabeth is... You keep men off at a distance. If you'd only relax, you'd have been married years ago.
Oh, stop it, will you? Now, here's the box office. I'm paying 41 cents to see Charlie Chaplin. If you two want to take a taxi, go on. I'll sit alone and I'll walk home alone.
Lavinia, you're crazy. We can't let you do that.
All right, then. 3 tickets, please. Here's your ticket, Helen, and yours, Francine. You can pay me later. Now, let's get inside.
This is a good movie.
Of course it's a good movie. Charlie Chaplin's in it, isn't he?
Well, yes, but after all...
Look, here's 3 good seats on the aisle.
Let's go on.
Look, there's Mr. Tubbs.
Ladies and gentlemen, the police have asked us to close early tonight so everyone can be out at a decent hour. Therefore, we're cutting our short subjects and running our feature immediately. The show will be over at 11. Everyone is advised to go straight home. Don't linger in the streets. Thank you.
That means us, Lavinia.
It means everyone.
It's starting
good.
Lavinia?
What?
As we came in, a man in a dark suit came across the street.
So?
He just walked down the aisle, sitting in the row behind us.
Oh,
right behind us?
Look for yourselves.
Oh, my gosh, he's there.
I'm going to get the manager.
Helen, no.
Stop the film. Turn on the light.
Helen.
Oh, Helen, you see how silly. All that commotion for nothing.
Oh, I'm so embarrassed.
When you ran up that aisle shouting, "Lights!" I thought I'd die.
Well, how was I to know he was Mr. Tubbs' brother from Racine?
Well, you could have asked him.
Well, I apologize. We shouldn't have stopped for those sodas. The police warned us.
Wash the police. I'm not afraid of anything. The lonely one is a million miles away by now. He won't be back for months. And the police will get him, then. Just wait. Wasn't the film wonderful?
I've seen it before. I'm glad I brought my sweater. I do feel a chill in the air.
So do I.
Do you suppose if we scream, they do anything?
Who?
The store dummies. The people. In those windows.
Oh, Francine. They're made of wax. Don't be silly.
Oh, it's getting windy. There goes my hair.
First, we'll walk you home, Francine.
No, I'll walk you home.
Don't be silly. You live way out at Electric Park. If you walked me home, you'd have to come back across the ravine alone by yourself. And if so much as a leaf fell on you, you'd drop dead.
I should stay the night at your house. You're the pretty one, remember?
Oh, bosh. Let's sing.
What do we sing?
Shine on, harvest moon. Up in the sky. It's just the wind blowing the perch swing back and forth.
Oh.
Shine on harvest moon, up in the sky. I ain't had no love since January, February, June, July. Your house, Francine. Good night.
Lavinia? Helen, stay here tonight. Oh, it's late. Almost midnight now. You can sleep in the parlor. I'll make hot chocolate. Oh, it'll be such fun.
No, thanks. We'll be fine.
Oh,
oh, Francine, don't cry.
I don't want you dead. Oh, you're so fine and nice. I want you to live.
Francine, I know this night has affected you. Believe me, I'll phone when I get home. I promise.
Oh, will you?
And tell you I'm safe. Yes. And tomorrow we'll have a picnic lunch at Electric Park with ham sandwiches and potato salad. I'll make it all myself. How's that?
All right.
You'll see. I'll live forever.
And you'll phone then?
I promised, didn't I?
Yes. Yeah, of course you did.
Good night, Francine.
Good night. Good night, Helen.
Good night. Now, I'll walk you home.
It's midnight.
Yes. It's tomorrow, isn't it?
Don't you feel funny?
How do you mean?
Well, when you think of us being out here on the sidewalks, under the trees, and all those people safe behind locked doors, lying in their beds. We're practically the only people out in the open in 1,000 miles, I bet. Hear it?
Yes, the ravine.
Here's my house. Look, the moon is sinking behind the clouds. I don't suppose it's any use asking you to stay, Lavinia.
I'll be getting home.
Sometimes...
Sometimes what?
Sometimes I think people want to die.
I'm just not afraid, that's all. And I'm curious, I suppose.
Curiosity killed the cat.
I'm using my head, Helen. Logically, the lonely one can't be around, not with the police all over.
The police are home with their covers up over their ears.
Let's just say I'm enjoying myself precariously but safely. If there was any real chance of anything happening to me, I'd stay here with you. You can be sure of that.
Maybe part of you just doesn't want to live anymore.
Oh, you and Francine, honestly.
I feel so guilty. I'll be drinking some hot cocoa just as you reach the ravine bottom and walk on the bridge.
Drink a cup for me. Good night.
Good night, Lavinia.
Malone. In 5 minutes, I'll be safe at home. In 5 minutes, I'll be phoning silly little Francine and... Whistling? I'll just walk a little faster. I can run and knock on one of those doors if I have to. It's just a few steps. A man.
long club in his hand. I could make it to that door now. Now.
Who's here? What a time of night for you to be out, Miss Nibbs.
Oh, Officer Kennedy.
Miss Nibbs, I'd better see you home.
Oh, thanks, but I'll make it.
But you live across the ravine.
Yes, but I'll hurry. I'll be fine.
I'll wait right here. If you need any help, give a yell. Voices carry good here. I'll come running.
Thank you. I'm sure I'll be fine.
Good night, then.
Good night. Alone again. Down the hill and then across the bridge for 70 yards, through the ravine and then up the hill to Park Street. 113 steps and only one street lantern to see by. In 3 minutes, I'll be putting my key in my front door. Nothing can happen in just 3 minutes. 180 seconds. Here goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Am I running? No, it just feels that way. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 steps. One fifth of the way. So black here. World has gone behind me now. World of safe people in bed, the locked doors, the town, the drugstore, the theater, the lights, everything is gone. Only the ravine now, black and huge. Nothing's happened yet. No one around, is there? 34, 35, 36. Remember that old ghost story you told your sister when you were kids? The story about the dark man coming in your house and you upstairs in bed with your feet all tucked in the sheets? And now he's at the first step coming up to your room. And now he's at the second step. And now he's at the third step and the fourth step and the fifth. And now the horrid dark man's at the 12th step. And now he's opening the door of your room. And now he's standing in the foot of your bed. I got you! What's that? At the bottom of the steps. A man under the light. Now he's gone. He was there, waiting. Nothing. Nothing. The bridge is empty. Fool. That's the story I told myself. What should I do? Should I call the officer? Oh, maybe he heard me scream. Nothing. I'll go the rest of the way. Stupid story. 41, 42, 43, almost halfway. Careful now, don't fall, not now. Footstep. Another one. Someone's following me. Someone's on the steps behind me. I don't dare turn around. Every time I take a step, they take one. Officer Kennedy? Is that you? The crickets and frogs, they're listening. The ravine is listening to me. To me. They must be hearing my heart. Keep moving. Faster, faster. Run! Only a little way. 108, 9, 10, 11. Now run across the bridge. Run! That's right. Keep running on the planks. He's following me. He's on the bridge. Don't turn, don't look. If you see him, he won't be able to move. He'll be so frightened. Just keep running. There. Across the bridge. Please. Please let me get up this hill. Now up the path. Now up between the hills. Oh, it's so dark and everything so far away. If I scream now, it won't help. I can't scream anyway. Here's the top of the path. Here's the street. Oh, let me be safe. If I get home safe, I'll never go out again. I was a fool. Let me admit it. I was a fool. I didn't know what terror was, but if I get home safe from this, I'll never go without Helen or Francine again.
Here's the street. Across the street. The porch. My porch. My house. I need just enough time to get inside and lock the door and I'll be safe. Unlock the door. Unlock it. There. Unlocked. Oh, now, see, quick. Slam it. Unlock it. Bar it. Lock it. Lock it. Tight. Tight. Home. Save it all. Save. 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 I'll never go out at night again. I'll stay home. I won't ever go through that ravine again, ever. Safe inside, the door locked. Wait. Look out the window. Well, there's no one there at all. Nobody was following me. Nobody running after me. It only makes sense. If a man had been following me, it would have caught me. I'm not a fast runner. There's no one on the porch or the yard. How silly of me. I wasn't running from anything. Ravine's as safe as any place. Just the same. Nice to be home. Home's a really good, warm place. The only place to be.
Good evening, Lavinia.
Later that night, an ambulance arrived and brought out a body on a stretcher. The body of a man. Lucky for Lavinia that the sewing scissors were handy that night. Very lucky. Was adapted from the story by Ray Bradbury. Featured in the cast were Barta Heiner, Beverly Rowland, Helen Beeman, Oscar Rowland, Dwayne Hyatt, and Bob Nelson. Original music by Roger Hoffman and Greg Hansen. Production assistant was Patrick Mead. Associate producer and director was Jeff Rader. Bradbury 13 was created, produced, and directed by Mike McDonough. Executive producer was Dean Van Eitert. This program was produced with the funds provided by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting through National Public Radio Satellite Program Development Fund. The program was produced by Brigham Young University Media Services, which is solely responsible for its content. This is Paul Freeze speaking.